Ireland, having experienced a period of dramatic growth, faced a huge collapse in the economy in about 2008, which really caused a devastating impact in terms of the number of people employed and the number of people who suddenly became unemployed, who would never have had any expectation that they would find themselves in that situation. Ireland had to respond to that in a number of different ways. In 2010, we entered a programme, the Troika programme, which actually imposed some macro constraints on government and requirements in relation to trying to restore stability in the Irish economy. And I suppose the first point there was to restabilise the banks. Secondly, was to enter into a period of fiscal consolidation and control public expenditure. And third, to actually create an economy which would foster and help the development of the economy and development of growth and jobs. In terms of social security and employment, there were two real aspects to this. First of all, there is an action plan on jobs, which is very much about creating the environment that will encourage growth, not just in terms of high-tech firms and major firms, but also in the SME sector, where the vast amount of employment in Ireland resides. In the context of social security, there was a very dramatic programme put in place called Pathways to Work, which is very much focused on trying to prevent people who otherwise would be at risk of entering long-term unemployment, trying to tackle them early, get them engaged, get them activated, and get them back to work. So that involved a huge period of institutional reform, bringing together different institutions, joining the Income Support Agency with the Public Employment Service, pulling together all of the income support schemes, including emergency scheme provision, and trying to come up with a more holistic one-stop shop structure for customers to engage with. What we're now rolling out is a service called the Intro Service, which is very much about when people come to us at the first instance, capturing information that enables us to profile them, to understand what their risk of long-term unemployment is, and to tailor a programme of intervention with them based on that risk. We also, at the same time, process in a very expeditious way their claim for income support, so that they get that, but they also are involved with us in this programme of development. We've introduced a new concept called the social contract, which means that people have to understand their rights, but also their responsibilities of engagement with us and the consequences of non-engagement. And what this is about is really positioning people to take advantage of opportunities, but also working with employers to create an awareness of the skills base that exists amongst the unemployed and to incentivise employers in terms of job creation and giving opportunities to people who are currently unemployed. One of the difficulties, I think, is that Europe almost consists of two different economies, and you have countries where employment is high, unemployment is less of a problem, and maybe there is greater focus on pensions and sustainability of social security. In Ireland, we do have those concerns, albeit a little bit later than the rest of our European partners. But our big concern is not just unemployment in Ireland, but also underemployment in Ireland, which arises in part because of an incentive that was put in place to help employers keep people in employment whilst they were restructuring their businesses. And we have a concern that that incentive may in fact become a disincentive if the economy becomes to take off, both in terms of influencing the behaviour not alone of customers, but also employers around the structuring of their business. And we have to work hard to try and do that. The real issue for us is to try and foster domestic demand, to try and generate interest in sectors like the retail sector, like the construction sector again, where we know we have a lot of skills currently available to us, where we know that we as an export economy, we can produce and deliver and service the needs of Europe. And a concern would be, of course, that we are so dependent on Europe as well, that the economy across Europe needs to take off for Ireland to achieve the success that it feels it can.